It's me, Mikey, back at long last with another vinyl video. I know it's been a while since I've made one. I think my last one was in April sometime. But honey, mama has been busy. I've been meaning to get to it. And there's just been so much going on. But I said Record Store Day is coming up. And I said I wanted to get in another video before Record Store Day because I want to do something special for that, like I always do. I said, let me get in my video with my pickups that I've made and got a whole bunch of great stuff to share and something special at the end. Got a little contest, more about that later. So got lots to share. Hope everybody's been doing well and let's get to it. All right, so I was excited to get this. As you know, I'm a big fan of Linda Ronstadt. And this past October, the Friday Music label, came out with a reissue for her 1982 album, Get Closer, which is one of my favorites. Love that album. And they've been doing a great job with Linda's past catalog. They put out special blue vinyl editions of Living in the USA. They did a pink marble version of Mad Love. So they are right on Linda's. They did like a live Linda set that was on translucent red vinyl. So they are definitely taking care of her catalog very well. So this edition, this is a special gatefold edition of Get Closer, and it's on a translucent red marble. So just gonna share that with you. Always love that cover. Absolutely stunning. So there's the inside. And if you ever purchased this album originally, we know it wasn't a gatefold. This was actually the inner sleeve from the original. So they made into a gatefold, as Friday Music tends to do. That's this, one of their special things that they do. But so here is the nice lined sleeve, and that's 180 gram red marble, but red translucent vinyl. That beautiful cherry red, Could You Die? Absolutely stunning. And I think there's another edition out there. I believe Barnes & Noble has an exclusive edition of this that's on gold vinyl, which I'm sure looks nice, but I felt like the whole theme, the aesthetic, the red vinyl, I said, that's what I really want to have. And I always envisioned it on red vinyl. And I always thought, I said, man, why don't they put this out on red vinyl? And sure enough, Friday Music took care of that. So, and this one has some great songs on it. Obviously, we've got the title track, Get Closer. And there's the back, isn't that cool? So there's the title track, Get Closer. The Moon is a Harsh Mistress, a great song by Jimmy Webb, beautiful song. I Knew You When, love it. Easy For You to Say, one of my favorite Linda Ronstadt songs. People Gonna Talk, Talk to Me of Mendocino. I Think It's Gonna Work Out Fine, which is the old Ike and Tina Turner song, classic that she does on here with James Taylor. Mr. Radio, Lies, Tell Him, which was done by the Exciters originally in the 60s. And Linda does a great version of this. Sometimes She Just Can't Win, and My Blue Tears, which is features Dolly Parton and Emmylou Harris. So terrific album. So glad to see it on a red vinyl pressing, 180 gram. Got this from Target, but I'm sure you can get it from mostly anywhere, Amazon, whatever. So, but it's out there. Check it out. All right. And so, you know, I'm going to have some colored vinyl exclusives. Just, you know this, right? Because I'm such a sucker for it. Now, this actually came out in November, but it passed me by quite a few times. When it came out, I couldn't get my hands on it because it was sold out. So, but this is self-titled Boston, their first album. And this was a Walmart exclusive. This was on turquoise vinyl. And I remember, jotting it down last year. I was like, oh, I want that when it comes out. And when it came out, it was sold out. So, but several months later, I was able to grab it. And I think Walmart is carrying it, at least online. You know, it's more well-stocked now. So I got a very good price. I don't even think this was $20, at least. But, you know, I don't have any Boston on vinyl. And I really should have, because I do love Boston. Brad Delp was such a great vocalist. Oh, my God. You know, just the range that he had. So, but this is their self-titled album. And there's the back. And just going to show you real quick. It's pretty much a no-frills release. You know, no special insert or anything. But there's that pretty vinyl. If you hold it up close to the light, it's probably hard to see here, but it is slightly marbled. So, and I played it, and you know, it's not, you know, the sound quality isn't fantastic. You know, they obviously didn't do too much in the way of remastering it or anything, but it is nice to have, you know, from a collector's standpoint. You know, it looks great. Again, I didn't have any Boston on vinyl, shame on me. So, and it makes a wonderful addition to my collection. So, but I'm sure there's remastered editions of this album out there, but this is the one I went for, you know. So, but great songs on here, obviously, More Than a Feeling. It's got my favorite by Boston, Peace of Mind. Woo, those notes that he hits on that song, oh my God. Foreplay, Long Time, and Rock and Roll Band, Smoking, Hitch a Ride, Something About You, and Let Me Take You Home Tonight. So, fantastic album by Boston, Walmart exclusive, turquoise vinyl. Pick it up. Okay, and here's one that I've been wanting for a little while now. It's actually been out for, I want to say, a couple years, but I actually got it on sale from the website YouDiscover, which I think I've talked about them before. I think they're owned by Universal Music. So they had on sale, or at least I was able to use a coupon for it. They had the half Speedmaster of ABBA's Voulez-Vous, which is one of my favorite ABBA albums. And they've been doing, there's so much ABBA stuff out there, and they've been slowly releasing their albums on half speed masters, but they can get kind of pricey. So, but when I can catch one on sale, or if I can use like a coupon towards it, that's when I, you know, choose to grab it up. And I had a special coupon to use towards it. So I got like my 20% off, whatever it was. And I was glad to get it. So there's the cool Obi-like strip there, mastered at Abbey Road Studios. And I'm just gonna take it out. Yeah. And that's one of my favorite covers, man. There's just nothing, this came out in 79. There's just nothing more disco than this, than the cover, the whole styling of it. I love it. So, but here's the gatefold. And there's the back. And let's see what's inside. It's gonna, so this is a disc number one. And it's got some great liner notes on the back. And disc two's got some great cover shots on that inner sleeve there. And another one on the back. Just absolutely beautiful. And just to go over the track listing, if you're not already familiar with the album, but As Good As New, that's one of my favorite songs. Voulez-Vous, obviously. I Have a Dream, Angel Eyes, The King Has Lost His Crown, Does Your Mother Know, great rocker there. And If It Wasn't for the Nights, another great one. Chiquitita. Chiquitita, Chiquitita, tell me what's wrong. Lovers, Live a Little Longer, and Kisses of Fire. So what a great album. You can't help but be in a good mood listening to this. You can't help but being in a good mood by listening to ABBA at all. It's just great, well-crafted pop music. I never get tired of them. And you know, they're still standing strong today, still popular, still getting offers of millions to, you know, regroup and, you know, reunite and get together for a tour, you know, but they keep turning it down. So, but again, if you've watched any of my videos, you know I'm an ABBA fan, so, you know, I can never get enough. So, but the half-speed mastering, I did play it. It sounds fantastic. And just going to take out one of the discs because I believe they are the same. Just to show you. And so there's disc one. And I believe disc two is the same. So I'm going to leave that. But if you can pick it up, it seems like every time I order something off of YouDiscover, like that's like the last copy they had. And so it vanishes after that. So, but I'm sure there's other outlets carrying it if you're interested. But that is ABBA Voulez-Vous Half Speed Master. Beautiful copy. Great price. Couldn't beat it. There you go. So, all right. So this one, I stumbled upon this one. I don't know how. I forget how I stumbled across this one. You know how sometimes you're listening to something or watching something and I'm like, I wonder if that's on vinyl. I wonder if this, you know, you know, at least that's what I do. Like I'll lay up there at 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, I wonder if they ever put out a collection on vinyl. I wonder if they have a greatest hits collection. So I know it's horrible, but I stumbled across this beauty and I ordered it off Amazon and this is the best of the Village People. Gorgeous, gorgeous 2 LP set. This is I believe this is a German import, but it is so beautiful. And catch, I love that silver foil detail there on the best. You can't get more disco than that, man. I love it. And I've always loved the Village People and without any shame. Ever since I was a kid. So, I mean, they just radiate just fun and positivity and just everything about them. So I've always loved them. But, and I've had CDs by the Village People, but really lacking for vinyl for the Village People. So, but I wanted something special. So, and there's several, at least one other Village People compilation out there, but I went for this one because I just really like the packaging and I think it had a few more songs on it. But again, this is the German import and there's the gatefold there. I know it's kind of hard to see the detail, but and there's the back. And there is a deluxe version. I mean, you would think this would be the deluxe version, but there's a deluxe version out there. And I think it's got a Macho Man t-shirt with it. I think if you want to pay like 70 or 80 bucks, that's out there. You know, not too many copies out there, but if you want it, it's there. But this is just beautiful. So it's got all the hits. YMCA, Macho Man, Can't Stop the Music, San Francisco, You Got Me, In Hollywood, Everybody's a Star, Ready for the 80s, I used to love that one, Key West, In the Navy, Fire Island, Go West, there's the We Want You Mega Mix 98, there is Hot Cop, and there's a song, Village People, Do You Want to Spend the Night, 5 O'Clock in the Morning, Sex Over the Phone, New York City, and In the Street. So a very cool collection. I've probably played it. I played it quite a few times since I got it. It's just so fun. I mean, I love it. Always been a big fan of the group. I proudly put this in my collection. I know some people, you know, they consider Village People as a guilty pleasure. Honey, ain't nothing to be guilty about. So, you know, love it. So just blasting it. I know my neighbors heard it halfway down the street when I was blasting the other day. So, but there you go. Best of the Village People. This is a new collection. I think this came out in the last year or so. Still relatively new. But check it out. So this next one is also a German import. This is from the My Star series. And this is one of my favorite singers. Definitely one of my favorite 80s ladies for sure. And this is a collection for Laura Branigan, who was just so awesome. She had a wonderful voice. This is a limited gold vinyl greatest hits collection for Laura. And I've got a greatest hits collection for her on CD, but no collection to speak of on vinyl. I don't even know if they ever put one out here in the States. But this is limited to, I believe, 300 copies. And this just came out in the last month or two, I believe. And I've got copy 76 here. But there's also a companion CD for this, which of course has more songs on it. But I went for the vinyl because I said, yeah, I've got a ton of Laura Branigan on CD. I said, I don't have a collection on vinyl. So, and with it being gold too, I said, yeah, it's a no-brainer. I'm going to have to go get it. But so it's got Gloria, All Night With Me, Solitaire, one of my favorites, Deep in the Dark, which is actually a rewrite of Der Kommissar by Falco. So it's like deep in the dark, uh-oh. It's awesome. But Take Me, Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow, Self Control, my all-time favorite Laura Branigan song. There's so much greatness in that song. The Lucky One, Satisfaction, Maybe Tonight, Spanish Eddie, and her track that she did with Stock Aitken Waterman, Shattered Glass. Awesome song. So a great representation of Laura's hits. And yeah, you know, they probably could have fit a few more on here, but we're at a loss for domestic Laura Branigan hits collections here in the States. So I've definitely wanted to pick this up. So very cool cover, nice shots of Laura. And just gonna take it out. And you know, nothing on the inside, you know, no lyric insert or inner sleeve or anything. Well, you've got this nice lined sleeve. But, and there you go. And it sounds just great. So, singer we lost way too soon, but her legacy lives on. That is Laura Branigan. So, pick it up. All right, so this just came out a couple weeks ago, and I know I don't have any of her on vinyl. I'm talking about Katie Lang. There's a brand new Katie Lang remix collection that just came out on Nonesuch Records, and that is Katie Lang Makeover. Could You Die? I love that cover. That cover, that has got to be one of the best album covers I've ever seen. It's just so cool. Love it, and she looks stunning. So, this is a brand new collection of classic remixes. This is on transparent turquoise vinyl. Gorgeous, and I'll show you. So this includes Miss Chatelaine, Sexuality, and it says, and her number one US dance chart hits, Lifted by Love, and If I Were You. And I love how the hype sticker says, constant raving guaranteed. So that's awesome. But it's a two LP set. And I'm sorry, I don't have, my contacts are fading. What else is on here? Just Keep Me Moving. There's Theme from the Valley of the Dolls. The Junior Vasquez 7-inch mix. The Consequences of Falling. Just Keep Me Moving. Which I already mentioned. Summer Fling. And so it's like multiple versions of those songs there. So, but very nice packaging. It sounds great. And both discs are the same. It's not a gatefold. This is more like a slipcase. But I'll take out one just to show you. So there we go. That beautiful translucent turquoise vinyl. And again, it's the same on discs one and two. So, but it sounds great. I was curious about this collection. I said, you know, I have no Katie Lang on vinyl. I said, this would be definitely something great to start with. So, Katie Lang Makeover. Check it out. So, I had heard that I had such a rough time getting this next album. It was like, first, you know, first they said it it shipped and it didn't, and then it didn't ship, and then they said it was delivered and it wasn't, and then it hadn't come out. So, but I was glad to get this. As you may or may not know, Philadelphia International Records is celebrating a huge anniversary this year. And of course, you know, Philadelphia International is known for the music of Gamble and Huff, which is one of my favorite songwriting teams, production teams, whatever you want. One of my favorite teams in the industry. And there's so many things coming out this year for that label. And there's box sets coming out. There's just so many cool things. If you ever get on their Facebook page, it's so cool to watch just all the stuff that they've got coming out, that they've got planned for this year. So, but to start with, they have a new collection. There's the Best of Philadelphia International Records. And this is this has been released on standard black vinyl, but you know, I went for Walmart's exclusive because they got it on hot pink vinyl, baby. Oh my God, I couldn't wait to get this. So it was a long time coming. I had to jump through a few hoops, but what the hell? So it seemed like it was a long time coming, and then I gave up on it, and then it finally showed up on my doorstep. So this is the Walmart exclusive version of this, and this has so many great songs on it. I can't take it off my turntable. I love it. And so I'm just gonna share with you, look at all those cool acts on the bottom there. We got everybody. We got the OJs, we got Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, the Three Degrees, Billy Paul. Let's look at all those greats. So there's the back. There's the back, and there's Gamble and Huff right there. And so just gonna kind of give you the rundown of what's on here. We've got Backstabbers by the OJs, The Love I Lost, Part One by Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, Me and Mrs. Jones by Billy Paul, When Will I See You Again? When Will I See You Again by The Three Degrees, You'll Never Find Another Love Like Mine by Lou Rawls, TSOP, The Sound of Philadelphia, that's MFSB featuring The Three Degrees, which we also know that's a theme to Soul Train, Ain't No Stopping Us Now by McFadden Whitehead, love, love, love it. If You Don't Know Me By Now, that's another one by Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, I'll Always Love My Mama by The Intruders, Love Train by the OJs, Close the Door by Teddy Pendergrass, and If You Only Knew by Patti LaBelle. So, very cool. And just gonna show you. Now, it didn't come with this little white sleeve. I just kind of put that on there because I'm trying to preserve the gorgeous inner sleeve that came with it. So, check this out. Isn't that awesome? Love it. All right, so this is that cool hot pink vinyl. Ah! Love it. Absolutely gorgeous. And although I wouldn't say this is 180 gram, it's not 180 gram, but man, it still sounds great. I've been playing it to death. So, but this is such a welcome release, and I'm interested to see what else they'll release this year. I think I've seen some something special for Teddy Pendergrass and some of the other acts. There might be a new OJ's collection. Don't quote me on that, but I think I did see something on that. And of course, there is a Philadelphia International Records box set that's planned. I think they're, if it's not out yet, I think they're already taking pre-orders for it. So that's the Walmart exclusive on the Best of Philadelphia International Records, man. Pick it up, man. It's so good. All right, so that's it for my new pickups. I do have one very special. I have some VCLT. And you know it's VCLT. I don't get that all the time. And when I do, it's always something very special. So I wanted to share This is courtesy of a member of the VCLT. If you guys don't know my boy, Eric Johnson, check him out. He's got his own channel. I believe it goes by Eric Johnson 1994. I just saw him on a, he does vinyl reviews on another channel in the VT, in the vinyl community. I think it's his buddy Reg. And I just saw one of their videos the other night, and they said they review everything, CDs, vinyl, and it's great conversation. But I got this from Eric, and he sent me Sheila E.'s Romance 1600, Could You Die? And it's in gorgeous condition. That is so beautiful. First off, that is one of my favorite covers. Just look at that. Absolutely stunning, beautiful, and the back is just as awesome. Look at that. Very cool. And I think I had mentioned to him just in passing, I said, oh yeah, I said I could never find a copy of that. You know, I've always wanted to. I think I featured Sheila E.'s in The Glamorous Life, the reissue that came out a couple months back. I featured that a couple videos back. And I just said to him, yeah, you know, I can never find Romance 1600. And he sent me a copy. Love it. Oh my God. So of course I'm going to take this out and show you, because this is just too much beauty. All right. And again, we go. And beautiful inner sleeve as well. Very nice. Very cool. This is just awesome, man. I've got so much great music to keep me busy. But this is the album. This has Sister Fate, which was one of my favorite songs back in the day. Dear Michelangelo, A Love Bizarre, of course. Toy Box, Yellow, Mercy for the Speed of a Mad Clown in Summer. And so I can't wait. I haven't heard a lot of these songs in a long time, so I can't wait to get reacquainted with this album. So, but it's in terrific shape, stunning. And again, for me, it hasn't been that easy to come by, so I was so thrilled when I got this. So thank you again. Shout out to you, my brother Eric. Thank you so much, honey. All right, so now, my lovelies, I got some used vinyl I want to share with you. And since the pandemic, you know, I haven't really been out and about shopping. You know, if I've been buying any records at all, it's been online. But, you know, it's been so nice. The weather's been getting so nice, and, you know, stores are opening back up. So just the last couple weeks, I said, yeah, you know, let me take a visit to Half Price Books. And I don't know if you guys here in the States, I know there's some Half Price Books locations out there in the States. I don't know if they're all over, but, you know, sometimes they do have a very good vinyl selection. So I just decided to venture out one day, and because I hadn't been in there in a long time, just to see what they had. And they had some goodies. I actually went back twice. So, let me show you. We have, oh my God, we have the gorgeous 1981 album by Miss Phyllis Hyman. And that's Can't We Fall in Love Again. Isn't that has got to be one of her most stunning covers. Well, she was a stunning lady. She was absolutely gorgeous. But this album is so beautiful, and it still had the wrap on it. And it's not one of her albums I was overly familiar with. I had seen it, but had never come across at least a decent copy of it. So when I saw this just sitting there, I said, oh yeah, I have to have that. Very cool. And here's the back. Check it out. Girl, you know, that was Phyllis, man. She was just breathtaking. Beautiful lady. So, but, this has, Can't We Fall in Love Again, the title track, You Sure Look Good to Me, Don't Tell Me, Tell Her, The Sunshine of My Life, The Love Too Good to Last, Just Another Face in the Crowd, I Ain't Asking, Tonight, You and Me, and, I think this came out right around the time she was in Sophisticated Ladies back in 81. So I can't wait to play this. And checked out the vinyl. It's in great condition. You know, just some dust, but no scratches or anything. So, and that's what I always look for, of course. And just want to share the inner sleeve. Beautiful. All right, so again, that is the great Phyllis Hyman. There you go. All right, so I have always been a fan of Chris DeBerg, but I have like some things of his on CD, but I definitely don't have anything on vinyl. And Chris DeBerg is just an early MTV favorite of mine. I mean, I know when people think of him, at least here in the States, you know, they think of Lady in Red, you know, which is cool and everything, but he had albums before that. So the first album that I was acquainted with that introduced me to him is 1982's The Getaway. I couldn't wait to get it because it had, of course, my number one track, Don't Pay the Ferryman, man. Oh my God, man. I love that video. I still love it. When I first bought an iPhone and I got iTunes many years ago, that had to be the first track I downloaded. You know, because I didn't have it on anything. So, but I'm so glad to finally have, you know, and I've got some of his other songs scattered across different CDs and things. But what really had me thinking about building up my Chris DeBerg collection was I'm on his, you know, I watch his Facebook page, and he, during the pandemic, he's been putting on these fantastic pandemic performances, especially during the height of the pandemic, and they were so great to watch. And I said, you know, and each song was just a killer. So I was just like, man, I need to get some more Chris DeBerg. So, and he's always very in touch with his fans, always, you know, like, you know, performing songs, sometimes doing it by request. I always thought he had like such a unique, very powerful voice, very a great emotional range, beautiful lyrics in his songs. So, but to start with, I definitely wanted to begin with The Getaway. So, that had, again, Don't Pay the Ferryman, Living on the Island, Crying and Laughing, I'm Counting on You, of course, the title track, The Getaway, Ship to Shore, All the Love I Have Inside, Borderline, which is another favorite, Chris DeBerg favorite, Where Peaceful Waters Flow, The Revolution, Light of Fire, and Liberty. So there we go, Chris DeBerg, The Getaway. There's the inner sleeve, hey. All right. And I can't wait to, I mean, I haven't done a proper needle drop on it. All I did was blast Don't Pay the Ferryman. this is one I definitely want to like give a proper listen all the way through. But I was just so excited to have that. I had to start with that. So check it out. So the next used pickup I made was Ellen Foley's Night Out. Now, if you're not familiar with Ellen Foley or the name, you know Ellen Foley from Meatloaf. She sang backup for Meatloaf before Carlo DeVito joined him. If you've seen the video for Paradise by the Dashboard Light, you see Carlo DeVito, but it's actually Ellen Foley's voice that you hear. So, but she has such an awesome voice, the powerful, you know, just that she had a grand, she and Carlo DeVito actually have terrific voices. I just love those late 70s rock, you know, female voices. But stop right there, I gotta know right now, before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? You're probably like, this bitch is crazy. But she had a fantastic voice. And just want to see, I think I read, this album Night Out. This came out in 79. This one was produced by Ian Hunter and Mick Ronson. So, but just love the styling of the albums back then. It was so cool. And I think this one has an inner sleeve on it. Yeah. She always reminded me of kind of like a rock and roll Liza Minnelli. She just had like those big doe eyes and everything. And she kind of has like the some of the same qualities that Liza Minnelli has in her voice, but just with that rock edge. Very cool. So I was definitely glad to get this, and I can't wait to play this because as much as I've loved her voice, I just, you know, don't come across her stuff, or, you know, I just haven't. So, but this was in great condition. And I was glad to have it. Let's see if I can, the print is so small. But this has got We Belong to the Night, What's the Matter Baby, Thunder and Rain, Night Out, Stupid Girl, Sad Song, Hideaway, Young Lust, and Don't Let Go. You don't hear much about her now, or Carla DeVito for that matter. And they were actually terrific for their time. And you know, actually, I need to check out and see what they're up to. But if you haven't heard her, or, you know, if you haven't checked her out in a while, check this out. This promises to be an excellent listen, and I can't wait to check it out. I can't wait to listen to it myself. So I picked up a couple LPs by my boy, the showman of our generation. And if you don't know who I'm talking about Mr. Barry Manilow, because I am a fanilow. And I've had so much Barry Manilow over the years across different formats, cassettes, singles, CDs, but there's a couple that somehow I just never picked up on vinyl, or maybe I came across a copy and it was crappy, or, you know, for one reason or another, there was just a couple that I never had on vinyl. So one that they had used and looking in very good condition was 1982's Barry Manilow, Here Comes the Night. Check that out. Check out all that leather. Go ahead now. I love it. That I think that cover's awesome. But cool album. I do know all the songs on it, but again, just never had it in this vinyl format. And there's the back. Look at him looking all dreamy. But this has one of my favorite Barry Manilow songs, Some Kind of Friend. When he came out with that in 82, that just blew my mind. Just that new wave kind of rock, a little bit of techno edge to it. I said, God, who is this? And which goes to show he can sing anything. I mean, he's, you know, very good at what he does. And he made that song work. It's such an awesome song. And of all the times I've seen him in concert, I wish he would perform that song more often. But that's got Some Kind of Friend. It's got his version of Memory from Cats. Let's Get On With It, Some Girls. I'm Gonna Sit Right Down and Write Myself a Letter, the old Fats Waller tune. Getting Over Losing You, Heart of Steel, Stay. Of course, the title track, Here Comes the Night. And another single off of here was I Want to Do It With You. I used to love that one. I want to do it with you. I want to do it. But great album. Again, just never had it on vinyl, and I was so glad when I saw it. And it's in great condition. Again, just dust. Needed a you know, a nice light cleaning, just had some dust on it, but it was a great copy. So, but that one, and they had another one which I never picked up on vinyl, which was his Greatest Hits Volume 2. Now I've got Barry Manilow CD hits collections out the wazoo, but I did not have this one. I actually have this songbook, but never picked up this on vinyl. So this has the majority, or probably all the hits on this one are from the early 80s. So there we go. And this has Ships, which I love, the Ian Hunter song. He did a great cover of that. Matter of fact, I think when I was little, that's probably the song that made me fall in love with him and his voice. Just that warmth that he does that song. Again, this has Some Kind of Friend on it. I Made It Through the Rain. Read 'Em and Weep, which was written by Jim Steinman. Put a Quarter in the Jukebox with Ronnie Millsap. Somewhere Down the Road, One Voice, the old songs, love it. Let's Hang On, his great cover of Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons hits. Again, this has Memory on it, and You're Looking Hot Tonight. So great hits album, Barry Manilow, great condition, couldn't help but pick that up. One I've had on CD for years, but I'd never had it on vinyl, was Captain and Tennille's Greatest Hits. Love them. And seems like in recent years when I did see this on vinyl, it was, you know, beat up. You know, you can probably find so many Captain and Tennille LPs, but, you know, how many are in decent condition, you know, when you come across them. So, but this one was, and it's got some beautiful photos inside. And it's actually like a little booklet, even, I guess, if you want to call it. Stunning photos of them. I always get a little bit sad now when I think about Captain and Tennille. I mean, they had such great music, and so sad that not just of Dale Dragon's passing in the last year or two, but you know, the fact that they had eventually separated before that. After being together for so many years, but they left some great music, and I know Tony Tennille is still out there singing and sounding fabulous, but you know, but when you hear stuff like that, it just kind of breaks your heart. But I will always love them, and I mean, Love Will Keep Us Together, Muskrat Love, Circles, The Wedding Song, we got Coming From the Rain, which is done by so many of my favorite vocalists, from Melissa Manchester, Diana Ross has a version of it, but Lonely Nights, Angel Face, Shop Around, love their version of Shop Around, so much fun. I Write the Songs, if you hadn't heard their version of Barry Manilow's Write the Songs, they got it on here. The Way I Want to Touch You, great ballad, so beautiful. Disney Girls, Can't Stop Dancing, and We Never Really Say Goodbye. And if I can recall, We Never Really Say Goodbye was the closing theme to their short-lived TV show, variety show that they had. So, but can't go wrong with some great, fun pop music by Captain and Tennille. So was glad to pick that up. In that same vein, I picked up one of my favorite Carpenters albums, which I've had on CD for such a long time, but never had it on vinyl, if you can believe it. And that is 1981's Made in America. And this is actually the last album they would record before Karen's untimely death in 83. But some great songs on it. This was in great condition. Looks like it hasn't been played. You can tell it's a cutout. But it's got These Good Old Dreams, Strength of a Woman, Want You Back in My Life Again, great, great track. When You've Got What It Takes, another great one, Somebody's Been Lying, I Believe You, Touch Me When We're Dancing, which was the big hit on here. When It's Gone, It's Just Gone, Beachwood 45789, they did a great cover of that, and Because We Are in Love, The Wedding Song. So, but, and a great insert photo there. Very cool. And again, great used find. Doesn't even look like it's been played. And just a great copy. So if you haven't heard Made in America, check it out. Karen was still in, despite everything that was going on in her life, she was still in fine voice in 1980, and they had a copy of 1984's Self Control, which is actually my favorite Laura Branigan album. It's just so awesome. I've had it on CD for years. I've had a couple of singles. I've had 12-inch singles for the title track, Self Control, but just never had the album itself on vinyl. So I was glad to see it, and glad to see it in good condition. And there's the bat. And this has got The Lucky One, of course, the title track Self-Control, Te Amo, Heart, Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow, Satisfaction, Silent Partners, Breaking Out, Take Me, and With Every Beat of My Heart. Yeah, no inner sleeve really on this one, just a standard Atlantic, paper sleeve. But again, it's in good condition, so had to grab it. All right, so one of my favorite country ladies for many years has been Miss Crystal Gayle. And this is her album, Miss the Mississippi. This came out in 79. Did I say that right? Miss the Mississippi. Yeah. This is 1979's Miss the Mississippi. And I've never actually owned this album on vinyl. I have Crystal Gayle on many formats in my collection, some vinyl, mostly CD. But look at that, isn't that such a gorgeous shot? And it's still in its wrap too, and it's great condition, used. And let me just show you the back cover. What a pretty lady. I always thought she's just one of the prettiest ladies in music, just gorgeous. I wanted to get this because it's got one of my favorite Crystal Gayle tracks, Half the Way, which was a huge hit for her, I want to say, late 79, maybe early 1980 as well. 1980 was when I remember hearing it the most. So that was a huge hit. And actually in that video for Half the Way, she's actually wearing this outfit. You could probably pull that up on YouTube, but I said, you know what, I've never even come across a copy of this. And when they had it, of course I had to grab it. Beautiful lady, beautiful voice. This is Loretta Lynn's little sister. So had to pick that up and was glad to do it. And I don't know if there's, is there inner sleeve? Yeah, there's an inner sleeve inside. No pictures, but lyrics, which is always good to have. And there you go, Crystal Gayle. So the remainder of my pickups, my used pickups, are 12 inches, and I just picked up a few, but there's some goodies. So I picked up the 12 inch for my girl Donna Summers, Love to Love You Baby, and it's in great condition, which I've never owned. With all the Donna Summer I have, I've just never come across this. So What nice detail for a 12-inch single, especially for that time. And it's got, it's got the lyrics. It's got the lyrics there. And the back cover for the single. There's our gorgeous Donna. Very nice. And so this has Love to Love You Baby on side one, and then side two is Try Me, I Know We Can Make It. So great condition, and there's that Casablanca logo, which I love. And there we are. So I was so glad to come across that. I'm like, hey, they didn't have to say nothing but Donna, just give it here. So there we go. Very cool. And here's one that I thought I had, and then I went back in my record collection at home and I didn't have it. I said, I'm about to get that. So this is one. This is Olivia Newton-John's Toughen Up, and this is from her 1985 album Soul Kiss. And very cool song. And so it's got the dance remix, and then side two's got the instrumental remix for Toughen Up. Toughen Up. The remixes are, the song was originally produced by her longtime collaborator, John Farah. I always thought his name was Farrar, but it's John, it's the Australian pronunciation, John Farah. And he always could produce and write wonderful songs. And the remixes are by Jelly Bean Benitez. This is again, this is from her Soul Kiss album, Toughen Up, Olivia. big time Olivia collector for many years, and so this must have been one that escaped me because I thought I had it and I didn't, so I went back for it and I was glad to get it. So all right, so one more 12 inch I got here. And I think on my last video, I talked about an album that I had not been familiar with by Samantha Sang, who, you know, did Emotion. She had a follow-up album called From Dance to Love, and the artwork on it, the photography was great. You know, I did some needle drops on it. Sounds fantastic. So what are the chances that I would come across the 12-inch for the title track? So there's From Dance to Love. I couldn't believe it. I said, the album I had never heard of by her, I come across the album and the 12 inch all in like a month's time. So, and she's on the label. That's very cool. And I'm trying to think what else is on here. Oh, the B-side is I'll Never Get Enough of It. I haven't had a chance to play this yet, but if it's anything like the album, I know it's gonna be fun to listen to. So, and you know me, I can never have enough disco. So there we are, Samantha Sang, From Dance to Love. Very cool. All right, so my last pickup, my lovelies, is actually a CD. And I had an Amazon gift certificate burning a hole in my pocket. And so I was thinking about one of my favorite groups from the 80s, that's Exposé. So Cherry Pop Records did a wonderful job with a deluxe edition of their first album, Exposure. They came out with a 2-CD version of it a few years ago. Lots of remixes, extended versions. And I love it. And I never, for one reason or another, picked up the second deluxe edition that Cherry Pop came out with for Exposé, which is their follow-up album, 1989's What You Don't Know. And I love that album. But for some reason, just never came across it. I don't know, maybe I was just waiting for the price to come down. I don't know what it was. But I finally picked it up because I said, yeah, I've said as an Exposé fan, I've got to have this. And there's literally so much on it. I mean, back in the day, I actually wore this album out, and you could see them all over MTV and VH1 back in the day. I mean, again, they are still widely considered one of the most successful girl groups of all time, but definitely the 80s. And this follow-up album was, trying to think, that writing is so damn small. I'm just like, Jesus Christ. So, but they did a nice job. This is actually a 3-disc set. You know, their the Exposure Deluxe Edition was 2 CDs. This is 3. There's like every remix for this album under the sun. So, but did a nice job. Check it out. Very cool. And if you lift up each CD, and I'm not gonna do all three, it's got, you know, each lady featured. Of course, Exposé is made up of Joya Bruno, Jeanette Jurado, and Ann Curless are the three members of Exposé. But you know the hits on here, of the title track, What You Don't Know. There was When I Looked at Him, which is a beautiful ballad. Tell Me Why. Your Baby Never Looked Good in Blue. Now That I Found You. Love Don't Hurt Till You Fall. Some fantastic tracks on here. And again, just loaded with remixes. And I'm trying to think if there's some demo versions on here too. There's alternate versions, of course. And might be some, there's a couple of there's a few unreleased tracks as well. But again, this is put out by the UK label Cherry Pop, and they're always putting out some terrific pop music from the 80s and 90s too. If you ever check out their website, it'll blow your mind. There's literally so much stuff. But that was a recent CD pickup. I don't buy CDs that often unless it's something special like this, and this was. So that is the deluxe version of Exposé's What You Don't Know. All right, so that's all for my pickups, but honey, I am not finished, because guess what I got for you today? I am gonna do a giveaway. We talked a little bit earlier about Philadelphia International Records, and it just so happens I have a second copy, and I wanna do a giveaway. Let's do a Philly Soul giveaway. I wanna give this to a brand new home, and I know there's lots of Gambling Huff fans, Philly Soul fans out there. Again, this is the exclusive Walmart edition on hot pink vinyl. So there's the back. So let's start the giveaway today. So this can be yours. All you have to do is just be a subscriber. As I always say, subscribe. And just let me know in the comments, what is your favorite Philly Soul song? And so it could be one by Gambling Huff, it could be something else, but it just has to fit into that context of Philly Soul, and you know what I'm talking about. So I think we'll let this run until Friday night, June 18th, till midnight, and then I'll announce the winner that weekend. How about that? All right. So, but that's it. That's the Philly Soul giveaway. And be a subscriber and let me know your favorite Philly Soul song in the comments. And you can have some hot pink vinyl on your turntable, baby. All these great songs, I guarantee you will love it. So, whew. All right, honeys, that is it. That's all I got for you right now, as if that wasn't enough already. So, but in the meantime, I am gonna be back with you sooner than expected, because we got Record Store Day coming up on the 12th, I believe, if I'm not getting too ahead of myself. It's coming up very soon. So be on the lookout for us. We'll talk about Record Store Day. I will announce the winner of our giveaway. And so we will meet again soon. In the meantime, guys, take care. Stay safe out there. Things are opening up. It's wonderful. We're getting some great weather. So getting back to some sense of normalcy, slowly but surely. See you later. Bye. We're passing up.